ask@huda.tv. A few pending questions from the last episode. The first is from Fatima from Nigeria. She asked about if there is any specific supplication or a recitation to be recited at the time of delivery to keep the devils away. Also, are there any supplications to be said in order to facilitate and ease the childbirth? I say, and Allah knows best. First of all, this process starts even before conception. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that if one wanted to have a husband and wife relationship, to have a sexual relation with his spouse, they should say, Allahumma jannibna shaytana, Allahumma inni, Allahumma jannibna shaytana, wa jannib shaytana ma razaqtana. O Allah, protect us against Satan, and if you are going to give us a provision, a risk, a child out of this relationship, then protect him or her against this shaitan as well. So this dua should be recited before having an intimate relationship every single time. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَضُرُّ. If this happens, if there will be a child, he or she will be protected from Satan. Second, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that at the time of delivery, once the baby is born, the first thing that the baby should hear is the adhan in the right ear. A righteous person or the father would call the adhan quietly, not out loud, in the right ear of the child, saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, all the way to the end of the adhan. This is the sunnah. So the first word that would ring in his ears would be the words of the oneness of Allah and magnifying and glorifying Allah the Almighty. That too will keep Satan away from him. As far as specific verse or surahs or dua to be recited, there was not a single surah prescribed or indicated to be recited at the time of giving birth or delivery in order to facilitate the delivery process. Yet, the Quran is full of verses can be used in situations like that. The ayat which talk about giving ease, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in one verse, he said, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah intends to give you ease. He does not want to give you difficulty and hardship. So you can also keep reciting this verse. You or the person who is giving birth or the father or a person who is standing next to the woman, you can keep reciting this verse. Surah Al-Sharh, فَإِنَّمَا الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَ. إِنَّمَا الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَ. Verily, with every difficulty there is an ease. Verily, with every difficulty there is an ease. You can repeat these verses. There is an ayah or a part of an ayah of Surah Fussilat which talks about delivery, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَحْمِلُ مِنْ أُنْثَى وَلَا تَضَعُ إِلَّا بِعِلْمِ. There is not a single female that bears a child, conceives nor gives birth, but by his knowledge and his leave. Some scholars say there is a verse which talks about what will take place on the day of resurrection, when the earth will throw out and bring forth what was buried in its stomach beneath it. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And when the earth brings forth its heavy weight which is inside of it, those who were buried since Adam until the day of judgment will be brought forth. They said also that can be recited. Some prescribe that it can be written by saffron, and then this writing will be dissolved in water. It would be wonderful if this water of Zamzam. Then the woman at the time of birth or a few days before giving birth can drink out of this water and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give her ease. Not to forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua of those who are in difficulty and hardship more than those who are in ease. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Naml, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءِ. Who is he that who answers the call of those who are in imminent need, in definite need, وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءِ, and removes the harm, removes the difficulties, and makes it easy. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one also can recite these verses. But as far as a specific ayah or a hadith has been indicated by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is no prescription for such case. Wallahu a'lam.